It's all a fugazi. You know what fugazi is? Yeah, fugazi, fugazi. It's a wazi, it's a woozy, it's a fairy dust. It doesn't exist. It's never landed. It is no matter. It's not on the elemental chart. It's not fucking real.
Right?
Do your dance, boy!
I built this shit! Me! Brick by brick!
We do a little trolling.
It's
called
we do a little
trolling.
Banana's
too
hard.
Who brought the trailer? Most times it be inspired. Niggas be inspired.
Who brought the paper?
First and foremost, your ejaculation, your nut is life.
My dance?
Listen, I ain't never believed that government conspiracies and shit.
In a room naked with some other niggas and some broad, them niggas looking at your ass. And if that shit is that shit is gay, and you get on some other shit, me and this man got nothing but respect for each other. Ain't never put no train, we ain't no motherfucking freaks. We some family men, we getting this paper. You know what I'm talking about? And I had to put that out there front because a lot of niggas doing a lot of free games and shit out here, man.
We are
natural selection and evolution would have taken care of all your fucking retard ancestors, but yet here you are.
That offends me.
Is that understood, little man?
Slap, slap, grab, choke, shut up, bitch.
It's typical for homo predators to try and cover their tracks using a cornucopia of strategies to shut people up.
Our will breaks you! God breaks Bill Gates! You understand that?
All dance. Delight me.
Welcome to war mode.
Dance!
You stand on the edge of the abyss. You are standing on the edge of the abyss.
I think that life is what it is, but life is not what's made of what life was.
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no?
No.
All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
This is for mine and yours protection.
I was just like sigil magic stuff.
It's just the only guy I got on my team, dude.
We'll be good talking about this stuff. If we got this going on, we're good. Dude. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, please, not during the song. We could do a whole one of just us doing fucking church songs.
Obviously.
I mean, fucking, you're just making me want to hear some of them now. I was an altar boy for way too long, dude. I was like a senior, super senior altar boy.
Yeah, I had to hear some of that before I got into the demonic shit that I was fucking watching this week, dude. But, and then I put that on last night with my cousin, and then it was immediately like, give me your best fucking church song.
Yeah, right.
What was the one?
I can't remember the names of them, but when they come on, I know all the words.
What was the one they fucking, they would blast on Christmas?
Dude, you know my memory's trash.
Right. All right. I mean, either way, it doesn't fucking matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, dude.
Yeah, I was watching, like, I always knew that, like, the Led Zeppelin shit with the devil, Stairway to Heaven, like, I always knew that was going on. Like, I got that. I got that they were fucking Satan worshipers. Or kind of fucked with that. I didn't know Satanic Panic. And then I watched this fucking thing on the Led Zeppelin curse. Do you know about the curse?
Tell me about it.
Okay, this is fucking insane, dude. So fucking, before we get into this, I'd like to explain to you a Faustian bargain. Are you familiar?
Dude, I asked Nick Bryant what that meant. He just didn't tell me.
Dude, it means a deal with the devil.
That's what I kind of figured from the context, but I like was like, dude.
I forgot that we didn't know what that meant when he said Faustian bargain.
Yeah, I was like, bro, pretend. I don't know.
If I would have watched this Led Zeppelin documentary, I would have just been shaking my head right along with him, like, of course.
Whom's Faust?
Faustian bargains go back forever, dude. Like, alchemical dudes, they all would make Faustian bargains. Fucking violinists, like, all, like, this whole fucking thing with people selling their souls to the devil, it goes back to, like, violin players. Like, this one dude said, there was, like, a goat violin player. He said he fucking fell asleep, and he woke up to fucking the man himself sitting right next to him. And playing a fucking song. And the dude frantically woke up, tried to write the whole thing down. It was the most complex thing in the fucking world. It's called The Devil's Trill. It's a fucking song that was written back in the olden days.
The devil went down to Georgia.
Yeah, so this shit's been going on forever. It's been in folklore forever. You get to Robert Johnson, same shit. Met the devil at the crossroad. Some people technically claim that maybe he didn't see the devil. Maybe he was more of a voodoo child himself. He was into the voodoo. He wasn't into the devil. It's a whole different fucking ballgame.
Universal entity.
Yes, but that piques these boys' interest. And this was fucking killing me when I was watching this video because all I could think about is a bunch of weird fucks like Jeff Beck, a young Jeff Beck, a young Jimmy Page, 15, mind you. They get into this fucking shit, and they get into it fucking hard. So they see, at 15, Jimmy Page is reading what's Aleister Crowley's book? Whatever his fucking goat book is, he reads that book and just goes, I found my thing at 15, dude.
Gets into theosophy.
I could never fucking do that. And they had it etched into one of the Zeppelins, thou shall wilt or whatever. It's Amen. Like, it's some like slogan Aleister Crowley always says, and then they have another one.
And he's in the Sgt. Pepper cover.
Yeah, and it's inscribed on the vinyls for these Zeppelin albums. And fucking Jimmy Page and his boys were into fucking electrical magic, and they thought they were casting a spell.
Slow down.
What?
What's electrical magic?
It's, dude, electrical magic is shit like this, like the electrical guitar, like things that have to do with electrics. And, dude, I'm just a fucking...
You're an acoustic boy.
Warthog in this shit. But he thought when this shit was scribed into, it was etched into the fucking shit. And all those records spinning at the same time, that's all the way around
a spell,
the world.
Casting a spell.
Yes, dude. So fucking rumor has it, Jimmy Page is fucking chilling and he's in the fucking Yardbirds doing pretty good. Mind you, the first guitar he ever used just appeared in his house. It was a Spanish guitar that was in a cupboard. Mom and dad didn't know whose it was. It wasn't the neighbors. The shit just appeared in his house. Self-taught.
Am I going to be able to sleep tonight?
Dude, I'm good on it.
Are you going to give me some closure here?
No. Were you there when he crucified my Lord? You'll be good, dude. Don't fucking worry about this shit. You didn't make any Faustian bargains, I hope. I asked Shane on my way here just to suss him out. He said he doesn't think he did. So Shane's good as well. But the weird shit, backtrack real quick. Robert Johnson, one of the most influential blues guitarists of all time, before he fucking had that shit where he went down and met the devil at the crossroad, he was AIDS at playing guitar. Everyone's like, dude, he's unlistenable. This dude is fucking horrible. Don't have him in my band. Get him the fuck out of my face. And then he comes back and he's a god on guitar, dude. It might be Ezekiel. They talk about Lucifer and he is the man when it comes to music. He was the music man.
The light bringer.
The light. Yeah.
Prometheus.
We don't gotta get into it. But
the Morning Star,
these like Jimmy Page gets all into this shit and he's like in the Yardbirds. He's a goat studio musician, kind of like a prodigy. Like he was really young when he was a fucking studio musician and he's just like beasting on a high level. Then he gets into the fucking Yardbirds and the fucking new Yardbirds And then after all that, mind you, teams up with Jeff Beck, who, if you watch him live at Ronnie Scott's, looks like the devil on stage. He fucking finds Led Zeppelin. You got Robert Plant, JPJ, Bonham, and fucking Jimmy Page. He founded all these guys. Bonham was a fucking bricklayer, dude. Beast of a fucking man. JPJ, a good Catholic man. A very good Catholic man. And Robert Plant, just an all-around beast.
Might have been why Terry Reid passed on it.
That's what I was thinking about, because like it was such a goat band. And like I was thinking how insane it must have been to be in the 70s and like the way the world traveled at that point, to be a global hit after like a year. Like to be known globally after a fucking year in the 70s is fucking insane. So these guys, they're doing good. Jimmy Page is very, very entrenched in esotericism. He fucking fucks with Aleister Crowley, and he is even in, like, he is in Aleister Crowley's, like, whatever he made after he left, like, Golden Dawn or whatever the fuck that group he was in. Jimmy Page is in his squad. So he shows them all fucking sigils and all this stuff, and they get the sigils. Robert Plant gets the fucking Feather of Truth. JPJ gets the fucking Holy Trinity, Celtic symbol. That's a good man. JPJ or fucking Bonham just has the drum. His shit is the drum kit, right? Zoso. No one knows what the fuck it means. No one knows what the fuck Zoso means, bro.
It's a spell.
Some people fucking say it's a three-headed dog that guards the gates of hell.
Oh, yeah, right. That's a guy, yeah.
So there's all sorts of shit, but if you ask Jimmy Page, he will not tell you.
Cerberus.
Mind you, one time he was very drunk and he spilled the beans to Robert Plant, and then Robert Plant said he was too drunk to remember. I asked him the next day, he said, I can't tell you.
Jimmy Page.
Jimmy Page got fucked up and almost told Robert Plant what Zoso meant.
Oh, fuck.
So he gets the band together. They're showing him the sigils and shit, and then he's like, yo, we should do this ritual magic thing that I'm into. Right? Right?
What a little weirdo.
Weird as fuck.
Oh, man.
And he's like, dude, we...
Don't come at me with any weird shit like this, dude.
I'm never going to do a Faustian bargain. That's on God, bro. I would not blasphemize. But he fucking does this shit. And, dude, let me tell you something right now. Between me and you, these four walls, all he needs is a drop of blood to get your soul. That's all you need. But what these dudes don't realize is dudes like Aleister Crowley were out in Cairo with his bitch summoning like high dukes of the gates of hell. And he's playing around like, oh, I'm going to do a fucking...
There's subways under the pyramids, dude.
Yeah, a lot of their shit is like Egyptian knowledge, which is weird. And I should probably change a pyramid on my back of my phone screen. But they make the fucking bargain. And JPJ's like, I'm not doing that. So it's just Bonham, Plant, and fucking Page. Mind you,
fuck, dude.
If this podcast came out in 1978, we'd be viral right now. But
what?
I mean, this is just such old fucking shit. But it,
oh, I get it. All
it
right.
Intrigued the living shit out of me, because yeah. I only thought they were just, it was just weird.
This is like
smut people put on them.
An 11-year-old YouTube video?
No, YouTube video isn't too old.
Oh, okay.
So right when this fucking Faustian bargain happens, Robert Plant gets in a car accident. And then flips his ass in Martin. So shit gets a little fucking weird. But Zeppelin's on the fucking up and up. Like, they're fucking killing
this is
it.
Like Zeppelin 2.
Zeppelin 2. Like, yeah. Yeah, probably Zeppelin 1 or 2. Mind you, not a lot of people know this, but Zeppelin 1 was... Jimmy Page was using a Telecaster and not his signature Les Paul. He was using a Telecaster given to him by Jeff Beck. Doesn't matter.
Side note.
Yeah, side note. Pretty cool, though. They're fucking killing it, bro. They are Led Zeppelin. They are gods. Absolute beast, all that shit. Then shit gets fucking weird, bro. Do you know about Bleskenhaus?
No, tell me.
Brother, Bleskenhaus is the fucking creepiest shit in the world. You remember how, like, when we talk about Zepp and you hit me with, like, oh, dude, they were chilling in castles.
Yeah, with Roy Harper. Yeah.
They were chilling in Bleskenhaus, bro.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Bleskenhaus used to have a fucking church on it. The church caught on fire and all the fucking inhabitants inside of it fucking burned to death. Then some fucking person built a little thing. It's in Scotland. It's on the Loch Ness Lake. Some dude built a fucking goat castle, and it was real weird. Bad fucking juju. And I think, I want to say, someone may have killed themselves. There's all sorts of lore about how, like, this place is fucking evil. And then Aleister Crowley rolls around and just goes, yeah, I'm going to buy this fucking place.
Come on, man.
Aleister Crowley buys fucking Bleskin House.
Come on, bro.
Goes ape shit, dude. Starts doing crazy shit. Even he said, I fucking went a little too far.
I mean, allegedly, he fucked babies.
Supposedly.
Just saying.
Yeah. And Aleister Crowley does all this fucking black magic in there, whatever magic he practiced, because I don't fuck with this shit. Right after he does this, like, crazy fucking summoning, which is, like, it's the 12 Dukes of Hell that he released through a fucking portal or whatever. His servant's fucking 10-year-old daughter dies and some other person. And then another dude loses his fucking mind because he sees what Aleister Crowley's up to and tries to kill Aleister Crowley's entire family. So they all fucking peace out. Place is fucking empty. Jimmy Page bought it. So the castle you're talking about is Bleskin House, which was owned by Aleister Crowley. Then Jimmy Page came around. I was like, I will fucking buy that place. Shit gets even weirder after that. Are you familiar with Robert Plant's unfortunate death of his son?
No, don't remember.
We'll get into that. So he's fucking chilling in Bleskin House. Weird as fuck. Mind you, he owned it for 22 years. He always stayed there. He stayed there for 3 months. And he owned it for fucking 22 years. He left because he said it had bad vibes. That's what Jimmy Page said. Yeah, bad vibes. And, like, dude, they said... It was too much for Jimmy. Like, imagine...
He was LARPing, right? They claim that they were, like, young kids LARPing, dude. That's all I'm saying, bro.
You know what's crazy about Bleskin House? It caught on fire a little while after Jimmy Page sold it. And bags of rubble will sell for $49 a bag there because of Aleister Crowley, which is fucking gay and weird. So all this shit goes on, and he's, like, getting up there as the fucking Satanist beast. Congratulations, Jimmy Page, you're the fucking man. Then a dude named Kenneth Anger comes along. Are you familiar with Kenneth Anger?
Mm-hmm.
Bit of a fucking dandy.
Mm-hmm.
Bit of a weirdo.
Mm-hmm.
Mind you, all these Satanists are like, do what thou wilt, serve yourself, fucking whatever.
Man, service itself is heavy with the Satanists.
So they fucking get into all this shit, and they're fucking chilling, and they really start to hit it off. And fucking Kenneth Anger, absolute psychopath, they met at an Aleister Crowley fucking auction. So Jimmy Page sent his bitch to San Francisco to buy a bunch of Aleister Crowley shit. He outbid Kenneth Anger. He also bought Aleister Crowley's old bookstore called the Equinox. Weird. Like, he's obsessed with Aleister Crowley.
What you're talking about is a network. And
yes.
It's tied in with, it's sort of like Scientology. The precursor to Scientology. Paul McCartney was in it, and it's connected to the Son of Sam. It's connected to Manson.
Yeah.
This is like all that shit.
It's fucking
It was
crazy.
Popular in this rock and roll world.
Yeah, they were going fucking ham, but fucking...
Yoko.
Dude, they become friends, going to fucking auctions, buying gay shit together, doing weird stuff. And Kenneth Anger is like, hey, I'm making a movie called Lucifer Rising. Have you watched it?
No.
Thank God, don't. That is electrical magic.
I just watched Caligula. That was fucking bizarre.
No, nothing compared to Lucifer Rising. Lucifer Rising is electrical magic. If you watch it, you are making a deal with it to take your energy, and you're giving your energy to Satan. Don't watch it.
Okay.
It is ritual magic that'll be put on you if you watch that movie.
It's on the do not watch list.
So you know how, like, back in the day, like, Eric Clapton had goat fucking soundtracks for movies?
Don't bring him into this, man.
I'm not bringing I'm just saying, like, you know how he has, like, he played guitar for movies, awesome soundtracks?
Mm-hmm.
They asked Jimmy Page to do this for Lucifer Rising. He says, abso-fucking-lutely. Mind you, at the time, he's addicted to heroin and cocaine. So the best he's got is 20.
Yeah, he's speedballing.
It's a 40-minute movie. All he could give him is fucking 20 minutes. And he was pissed, dude. Which it doesn't make sense to me because these Satanists fucking freak out on each other. Like, what the fuck? You were supposed to help me? It's like, dude, you guys are all about service to self. Like, you honestly thought he was going to give me 40? I mean, get real, dude. Like, if you're fucking worshiping the dude, like, get real. So Jimmy Page completely just shits the bed on it.
20 minutes is a lot. It's like 5 songs.
So much, dude.
Yeah.
But, I mean, he thought he had the fucking man beneath to help him do all 40 minutes. He thought it was going to be fucking legendary. Then it's just like a kind of go fuck yourself. I'm not fucking doing it. Whatever. Kenneth Anger goes ballistic, dude. Puts a full-blown spell on these boys.
And he's like, out in the public, you can look it up. He's like, I'm putting a fucking spell on you. You guys are fucked.
He's throwing hexes on Zep.
I forget the person he summoned to go after him, but it's fucked.
Best not to say his name.
Best not, yeah. So he fucking summons these guys to go after fucking Zeppelin. What happens? Robert Plant had a fucking very young boy. It's heartbreaking watching these videos of Robert Plant out on the fucking fields doing all this shit, chilling. This goes down. Robert Plant immediately gets sick, gets laryngitis, and Zeppelin's world tour that was going to be like the best world tour they ever did gets shut the fuck down.
This is when they're at the castle?
I don't know.
After the castle?
It's after Lucifer Rising. He owned the castle for like 22 years, so I don't know how long.
What Zepp is this?
I don't know.
All right, so this is after two?
Definitely after two.
Okay, all right.
Because they're fucking selling everything out. I think this was going to be like the Zeppelin 2 or 3 world tour.
Okay.
But fucking Robert Plant gets laryngitis, cannot sing, bro.
Mm.
Very fucking crazy. Then shit starts kind of hitting the fan a little bit. They're going to go on tour. Robert Plant's fucking 5-year-old boy dies of a fucking weird illness. Guy just fucking croaks. Then fucking Bonham. At this point, Bottom's a fucking booze hound. And he was at some recording or some shit. And like, we're going to take you home. They bring him back to his bed. Dude throws up in his mouth, completely shit. And then after that, they were just like, yo, Zepp is done. So this dude put this fucking spell on them. All this shit fucking took place. Zepp is done. And then I'm watching videos of Jimmy Page after I watch this documentary. And he's playing Stairway to Heaven and shit, like 80 to 85. He's so bad, it's disgusting how bad he is a guitar compared to what he usually is. Like, this dude was fucked. He was fucked on drugs, all that shit. And then they just never, I mean, that was the end of Zepp. This dude put a fucking hex on a Satanist.
So that's the Zepp curse.
The Zepp curse is
this Kenneth Anger.
Kenneth Anger did this because he didn't deliver on Lucifer Rising.
And now there's a movie I can't watch. I wish you never told me about it. Just because I don't even want to fucking...
Yeah, the dude wouldn't even show video of it. He was just like,
I'm gonna try to forget this.
You can try, but it just really piqued my interest because I always think about you talking about Led Zeppelin just chilling in castles and shit, and then I was just like, holy fuck, it's Boleskine House.
Yeah, I mean, that Aleister Crowley shit's fucking nuts. One of my buddies got into it, RIP. I mean, I don't want to talk about his soul. Wherever his soul is, he's lost, man.
Yeah,
you know, that man's gone.
It was fucking, it's crazy, and it's sad how fucking, like, how shitty this dude was. And then, I mean, looking in his face and shit, you're like, something's wrong. Like, something was insanely wrong.
I wonder what brings someone to go for a Faustian. Because you got to be like, you got to think that you're going to be something.
You got to think you know more than you know.
It's like, oh, yeah, you know, make me the god. Make me famous. It's like, you don't want that, brother.
You're making a deal with the fucking devil.
It's this Tenacious D movie all about it.
For real. Yeah, we just putting some things to bed in my head, Faustian bargain, figured out what the fuck that means, can use it in a sentence. And the Zepp stuff, I get my rocks off to some music fucking folklore, so I'm sorry about that, but, you know.
Hey, get it out of your system, man.
I got it out of my cyst, but it was really sad when I saw fucking Robert Plant's kid die. That shit fucked me up.
Yeah, right.
Kid was literally like 5 years old, had hair just like Robert Plant.
It's very sad.
Yeah, it's fucking insane.
So they only have really like what, 4 albums, 5 albums?
Yeah, kind of.
Something like that?
Yeah.
So they had a good run.
Yeah, but you listen to some of their songs and it's like, fuck, bro. Like, people, especially back then, if you start hearing that stuff and what the dude did with guitar, it sounds like weird fucking shit. Like, I get why people were saying they're all deviled the fuck up.
Right.
It was just very scary.
And the sigil stuff. Which still goes on today. People are casting spells every day. We don't know what the fuck's going on. We are in a spiritual war, dude.
For real.
I drive around thinking about that shit. Like, I drive around thinking, like, I can't give in to the darkness and the negativity because then they'll win.
For real?
Like, and I'm like, if I can turn my ship around, like, everyone can. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's all I keep thinking, like, I have to do this for the team.
Dude, I 100% agree with you. I'm out here... I went out on dates with fucking witches and I got stricken with fucking sickness. I lost my mind a few weeks back, dude. I'm getting fucking shit put on me. And I'm trying to be nice. That's for the Patreon. Don't be rude. That is for the Friday episode. We won't talk about that right now.
You have a temperature.
I'm man of the coach. But yeah, it was crazy. Like, dude, every time Trump, remember when Trump had COVID and all the witches were on Twitter putting fucking sigils all under his pictures and shit? The shit was fucking bizarre.
I feel like witch is like a phase for all chicks, dude.
Is it really?
I'm pretty sure, man. And there's so many girls that I've like messaged on online dating that like pretend to be witches. One chick has like fucking beard hair. I feel like bad about starting out talking to her.
Beard hair?
Yeah, like she fucking, whatever, man. She sent me a picture and I was like, oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Not a big deal. I'm not that. You know I'm not picky whatsoever, dude.
Not at all. Baggies can't be choosies.
Yeah, that's a tough one, though.
Yeah, I was just fucking, I was real fazed by all that shit. I never knew the shit about the sigils. I know a kid who has a tattoo of the sigils on his arm, and he's like my age.
Dude, just think about if it is something that it does cast a spell or has an effect in the spiritual realm. Think about how many kids carve that shit in their desk, put that shit on the back of their car.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, there's something in it. Especially like when you see like how obsessed all these people are with like symbolism and shit. It's like there has to be something to it. If the dudes are that fucking pumped on it, there's really like
symbolism will be their downfall.
There's something to like religion. If you go to a Catholic church, like something comes of that. Even if it's not magical, like the way they practice, they bring on, they do good, good happens. Like you're doing all this fucking bad shit.
I don't know, man. When I was a little kid, I had like a little notebook like that, and I would take my favorite Bible stories and I would cut stuff out of magazines and like make collages.
Are you serious?
Oh yeah, dude. Like I loved
Wholesome much?
Like I loved fucking I loved it. But like, and everybody was like making fun of me about it. They're like, dude, you're gonna be a priest, and I was like, that's sick. Yeah. When I was like 8, I was like, that would be sick.
Yeah, before you unlock girls in your brain.
I was like, well, of course, that would be awesome. But then I got, like, as soon as I found out about, like, Greek myths, I was like, this is better. I was like, this is like that, but way cooler.
Were you drawing it and shit?
Yeah, I was, like, drawing. I had, like, a little one of Noah, one of, like, fucking all the bros, dude, Moses. I had a sick amazing Moses burning bush. I would work on them at night.
Dude, your mom must have been so happy.
My mom and dad were happy until I was, like, 13.
Then you started.
Then I started getting Zeppelin posters with black lights.
Did you really? Spencer's. You had a Zeppelin poster?
Yeah, dude.
Your mom let that shit in your house?
Yeah, man. I started throwing knives at it.
Are you fucking kidding me? Why?
I was fucking 13. I was going nuts.
Why are you throwing knives at it, though?
I was nuts, dude.
That's fucking unstable shit.
I thought it would be cool to learn how to throw a knife. And I was throwing it at the wall, and the poster was like covering the holes.
Yeah, that is kind of fucking a thing where you just have zero clue about anything. I did that with my dad.
When I was a kid, I was fucking retarded. I used to hide shit. This is what I was bugging out. Remember when Mac was like, dude, stop videotaping me?
Yeah, yeah.
Like when I was little, I used to hide shit in the air vents.
Really?
And like, dude, I know it's fucking weird, right? But like, it's kind of important for little kids to like have hiding shit from their parents.
Yeah,
and be on their own little adventure.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It is
fucking bizarre to have this surveillance state on your own kids. At 4, 5, 6 years old.
Yeah, with the
video cameras in their rooms and stuff.
With the Internet of Things and all that stuff, I'm not too pumped about that, especially with Vault 7 and the people that are behind that. Like, they try to give them away now. People have the things for your dogs in your fucking kitchen, and they got fucking, they'll give you, you get a security system, like, oh, we'll give you an in-house fucking camera.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, bro, what if me and the old lady want to get a little cheeky breakfast bang? You guys going to watch Verbo?
Oh, yeah, man.
Nah,
they got everybody. You got it now.
Yeah,
they got everybody on that though.
It's crazy that they just fucking, it went from like fuck the Patriot Act to like, dude, I got cameras around my house and a fucking inside camera in case someone breaks into my house in the suburbs.
Yeah, voluntarily. Yeah.
Yeah, no bueno for me. But dude, I have a fucking clip to show you that it will ties you, and it ties into these fucking weird Satanist people. And the spells that are being cursed, and like they're going absolutely batshit at the whatever that is, Capitol Hill for the fucking Roe v. Wade shit. And then they want you to take them seriously.
I mean, that just can't be good.
No way.
Like there's like, I've heard all, like my whole life, I've heard all the arguments and stuff, and I just can't, it just can't be good, dude.
There's no way in hell that is beneficial to society whatsoever.
I just don't see it. Like, I can't figure it out.
Yeah, there's definitely nothing, but ready, watch this. And mind you, this chick, you can try to read along with what she's saying, but in the very beginning, this is a white woman in sports bra and biker shorts, and she immediately code switches for some weird reason. Ready?
Yeah.
Points at a black dude.
Damn, she's twerking. That's hilarious. Jesus Christ. I'm gonna bust a fat old load on you. She looks like Sarah Jessica Parker.
Could you
imagine? That's rugged, man.
That's like this chick is twerking in front of people that are just trying not to get babies killed and fake jerking off onto them. Be like, why can't I get an abortion? It's like, okay. We'll make an exception. You can get as many as you want. Just don't make any more of you, yeah, you please. Wretched fucking whore. Yeah, they're just going down there fucking freaking out. Same with this. Like, there's chicks doing that. And, like, there's no redeeming qualities about these people that are fighting for it. And, like, I get the fucking rape shit. But, like, if you are...
I don't.
What do you mean?
I don't get it.
I get how that could be an argument. Because I know you're literally killing someone. But, like, in their fucked up brains, I can understand how maybe that's an argument. But if, like, if you're putting all your time and effort into it, something's fucked up. And then, like, we sit there saying, like, what do we got to do to get pussy? If this is it, I will stay incel for the rest of my life. There, if you go to these fucking events and this happens to your voice because of screaming, you've lost the plot and you should restart.
I will not be stopped.
This guy's talking about abortion.
I will not be stopped.
Two microphones.
We are the most powerful force in this earth.
Dude, I mean, what's going on, man?
Like, there's no way you could do that and feel comfortable with yourself unless you're heavily medicated.
I'm just, all of this stuff confuses me. Like, why doesn't anybody have to work? I barely have time to do anything.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, what is this?
I mean,
and dude, I don't know. How does a dude get that passionate about this?
There's no way.
Like, to me, I think it is just chicks that don't want to be pregnant.
Yeah.
It's a fucking year of your life.
Mm-hmm.
You can give the kid away. You know what I mean? You don't have to kill it.
You have to be fat for about 7 of those months.
They can exist in the world.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It is kind of fucked. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
I think it's fucked.
I just, like, when I see the videos of those people fucking going down there and just losing their mind over abortion, it's like, there's so many things you could be really passionate about, and this ain't it.
Yeah, nah. That's fucking wild, dude.
Yeah, they're literally giving their all and doing, like, it's the same with, like, the pride shit. It's like, why are you guys, like, fucking getting naked and shit? Like, why are you jerking off at a fucking abortion rally? Like, none of this makes sense. You guys could just chill like everyone else.
And I get the vibe off the pride stuff that, like, that's what they would be doing if it wasn't for us. Like, we hold them back
from this. If the parents weren't home?
Like, that we hold them back from this life.
Yeah.
And be proud, like, that you're, like, really, really you're like this. But, you know, you have to button up and, you know, put your handmaid tail shit on during the rest of the year. But pride week, fucking dicks out, balls out.
That's hilarious. Like, that is definitely a very believable thought process. But, like, there's dudes who like to get shit in their mouth.
Oh, yeah.
And they have to show up to work and literally not tell anyone, I like people shitting in my mouth. There's no parades. They're not like, this is why we can't live.
But it's not like that.
What do you mean?
Like, the world isn't like that. Like, you can walk around and be like, I like to get shit in the mouth and no one cares.
Yeah, true.
I mean, the internet's out now, dude. Everybody knows about all this shit.
Yeah.
It's not shocking fucking, you're not shocking anybody.
Yeah, it's just fucking.
Aleister Crowley could still shock people today, but he's one of the only dudes.
Yeah, he's a fucking sick ticket.
If they had a Satanist week and they got to have their Pride week, that would blow your mind. If it was like spirit cooking on a street,
like sacrificing goats and
shit. Yeah, like this is what we do, and it's like blood magic, and people are like coming into bowls and fucking rubbing it on people.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Opening portals up. I'm like, yo, guys, fucking nah.
I saw Caligula this week, dude. It's like a fucking Hieronymus Bosch painting brought to life. It's fucking insane.
Nice reference, five people get. Yeah, fuck. I don't understand how they made that
more
movie.
Well known than you think.
Yeah, I mean, you're talking to an absolute fucking retard. I don't understand how, like, was that movie just in, like, jerk places, or, like, was Caligula
Dude,
in
I have
theaters?
No idea. It was before I was born, but it's made by Bob Guccione and Tinto Brass, pretty, like, famous pornographer types. I mean, it's just, like, starts out with clam. I'm like, all right, this is sweet. But then it's just endless cocks, dude. It's like, it's a fucking whirlwind.
Yeah, that'll happen.
It's nuts. It's a variety of birds.
Yeah, you get fucked up, especially back in the day when I was watching like Real Sex. I'd be like, all right, here the fuck we go, baby.
It's the same like Real Sex. Yeah, like I'm sure that they're probably like shocking the world with this shit, but I mean, bro, it is. I watched it. I was watching all those Roman Empire things, and I got way into like all the Roman emperors, and they started talking about how Caligula just like loved sissy, and it's just a thing.
Was that on the table back then? Like,
no, it wasn't. So like,
it was taboo.
He was a young paranoid emperor, and these historians that are on the Netflix thing are saying like he's got a bad rap because his setup makes sense.
What do you mean?
Like, dude, he was betrayed as a youth. Tiberius the emperor killed his dad.
Okay,
his dad was next in line.
Right.
So like, he was paranoid from as a child.
So you want to keep it in house.
He wanted to keep it in house, Egyptian style with Sissy. And then Sissy, the first Sissy, was not conceiving. So then he moved on to the next sister, and then the next sister. So he had like a three-sister quad triad relationship of bays going on for a while.
Oh my God.
But in the movie, like, they don't do that. It's just the one Drusilla sister is in the movie, and then
Drusilla.
Helen Mirren is one of the chicks, and I was like, all right, I'll just watch Helen Mirren naked, but I had to suffer through a ton of fucking insane shit to see it.
Yeah, you're out here acting like you're in fucking second grade as if porn doesn't exist.
Bro,
just suffering through
dicks. I was just like, this might be cool, you know? It's a bad movie.
I mean, I would
assume. Peter O'Toole's hilarious in it. He's like, little fishies, swim, my little fishies.
was that at the fall of the Roman Empire? Like, was that towards the end when they talked about
all this?
I don't know,
man.
Like,
they're always talking about the fall of every empire. I mean,
yeah, they got a joke with that.
Yeah. I guess if it's not expanding, it's falling.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you can't maintain. You just expand until it's over.
Yeah, you were fucking me up. Like, I wasn't even thinking when you were talking about, like, them making lines in Europe, and how it was just like, yeah. Like, these are the lines now. Like, these people, I mean, it's probably not that crazy that these Roman emperors were just like, I mean, I'm not going to fuck any of these weirdos. I'm just going to fuck my sister. Like, why not? But these people didn't understand fuck all. And then in a very short amount of time, they made fucking countries and all that other shit. And now it's been wars ever since.
I don't know. I mean, in the 1800s, when they made the nation states, like, it kind of there was trouble brewing for a while.
Really?
And then it was World War One, yeah.
Yeah, that is.
It was like
50 insane.
Years of like, why is this here? Why is this not
that
ours?
That must have been like an OG Davos then.
Yeah, oh yeah, definitely.
That's fucked. Imagine trying to pull that is just crazy.
Yeah, they did. There's been a bunch of Davoses, dude.
Really?
The elites are always doing this.
Yeah, it makes zero sense. But speaking of elites, did you see the Will Smith thing?
Come on,
no,
man.
Just fucking interesting.
Speaking of elites, I was fucking bullshitting with Dom at work, and he gave me like his history of golf. It's fucking fascinating, bro.
What do you mean?
Like, I don't know how true this is. This is just Dom sitting on an empty 5-gallon bucket, hitting me with the history of golf.
This is the shit I live for.
Fucking, so sailors used to roll up to Scotland, and they had to walk like 3 miles into the town. So on their walk, they would play a game where they would get a stick and a rock and try to hit it, like, see who could hit it the farthest.
Yeah.
See who could hit that hole. See who could hit that stick. And, like, they would walk to the town, then they would get drunk, fuck some whores, and then walk back all drunk and play the back end. And that was, like, the dawn of, like, Scottish golf. And where, like, they'd be...
It's the exact same thing.
Say they'd be playing, and there'd be a bunch of sheep. The sheep would, like, keep the grass real low.
Yeah.
Or, like, they would eat the grass too low, and it would make, like, it would just be sand. You know what
Holy
I mean?
Fuck.
And that's how the sand trap started, yeah. It's fucking wild. And then I watched the whole thing about like all the different like golf clubs that they used to make because they never used to make courses. They just would keep making weirder clubs to try to get shit out of like 5 inches of grass.
Are you fucking kidding
yeah,
me?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That is fucking insane.
And it didn't become like an elite thing until the late 1800s.
Yeah, that's with like, there's a, but like, especially over
dude,
there.
It's, golf is fucking ancient. It started out.
How old, like what
bunch,
are we talking?
A bunch of European countries had their own version of stick games where they would just kind of be like, just two dudes with.
How could you not?
Two dudes with sticks being like, yo man, I can hit that. Like, and then you're hitting a rock and you're like, I could hit that tree.
Oh, fucking cook's calling me twice. You're good, good.
So it's like, you'd be like, all right, dude, I could hit that tree over there. And it's literally just the evolution of that game.
It is fucking hilarious because you watch
now
like,
they're like in break now. Phil Mickelson like broke away. He's in Dubai playing whatever the fuck.
That shit's hilarious.
I love
bro.
It, dude. Yeah, I love Phil. I always bet on him.
It's didn't you win?
A couple times.
Couple. Yeah. Yeah. The them like that must have been amazing. Them making up games because like when you watch Braveheart and shit like that, like they're just throwing shit and like being strongmen. It's fucking amazing.
Yeah, pretty much like maybe like 150 years after Braveheart is what I'm talking about. Where they're walking into the town. Yeah. Like, that's the golf is like fucking 14, 1500s.
Imagine just having your stick game take off.
Yep. Yep.
That would probably
if they
be
could see
amazing.
It today, you know?
They would be fucking mind fucked.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But the shit I was going to say was the bro, the Biden who fell.
No, the buddy.
I legitimately, like, Rogan and them were talking about it yesterday on that episode. I don't know how an 80-year-old boy is falling like that and not really fucking hurting.
So you don't think it's him?
It must be. I don't know. Like, he must have a million fucking body doubles at this point. You see, like, there's so much shit on his face being fucking...
Yeah, well, also, like, when my grandpa was in this leather jacket phase, he could have done anything. He would go on walks. The cops would find him. He would be, like, 3 miles from his house with just a t-shirt on in the winter.
Wim Hof.
Yeah, well, what I'm saying is, like, Biden could fall, be bruised to fuck, elbow to ankle, and not know it, and just be in kind of, like, a weird shock. Like, dude, when you're that old and you're that fucked up, like, your, like, pain receptors, nerves, everything's on slow motion. So he could have fell, popped back up, and, like, been in a ton of weird pain and not known it.
True. Yeah, like, just from watching my pop-up when he was, like, late 70s, that dude used to crush Budweiser, a lot of it. And then, like, every now and then just take a spill and it was the hospital.
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure that they got Biden on, like, a world of cocktails.
That must
you know what I mean? It's probably,
insane.
Like, wake up, IV drips, fucking, here's this. Like, the amount of medicines that old people are on is insane.
You know Jill's getting a stiff one, though.
Come on, man.
They probably got him on.
Your head's
he probably,
in the gutter.
I mean,
head's in the gutter.
The fucking, the level of pervertness that is in this family... You know he's asking for a little shot of something extra for Jill.
Hey, man. To each their own.
Speaking of fucking pervert.
Hunter's a bit of a Caligula.
For real, bro. I was literally just about to say that.
Little boots.
That we spent an entire car ride from the suburbs to Philadelphia trying to find a video of Hunter Biden getting a foot job.
She didn't know her foot could do that.
Dude, I watched it on my big screen.
Okay.
Turned the fucking volume all the way up. Two other people with me. He 100% says, hey, Natty, look.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
And then proceeds to rub his semen on his stomach.
Yeah, and she says, I didn't know my foot could do that. And I don't think whores say that. I think teenagers.
They know.
I think
a
teenagers
whore,
say that because whores know what foot jobs do.
You hired them for that. It's not, they're very capable of doing those things. But that video, I mean, it is just a matter of time. Until this shit comes out, and I will talk about it until I'm fucking blue in the face. This man is raping his fucking niece. Please, someone fucking do something about this. Like, it is absolutely fucking clown world insanity that shit is going
this
on.
This is what the Romans did. They went in the streets and they did graffiti all over the walls, like literally saying the same shit.
What?
Caligula's fucking his sister? Like, what the fuck? They held incest as the highest taboo in Roman culture.
Over bestiality?
Over bestiality and pedophilia.
Shoo.
Incest was, like, the one no-no. So, like, when Caligula busted it out, all of, like, the elites and the senators were like, yo, bro. And he like went nuts. He was trying to make himself a living god, make people worship Drusilla. I mean, he goes nuts. He starts talking to fucking horses and stuff. But I don't know. The historian said that he gets a bad rap and that some of it might be fake news.
Right. True. I mean, it is.
He had a lot of enemies. There was like a crazy fucking conspiracy. He had two major conspiracies against him to try to kill him.
To murder him?
Yeah. He survived two coups.
It is
one of them involved his sister. It's called the conspiracy of the three daggers or something. It's fucking crazy.
This is what I miss about old TV, just because I haven't watched it in so fucking long. When you were scrolling through channels and I saw a dramatization, I'm staying on that for at least 20 minutes.
This reminds me of old TV. I watched this like 3 years ago. I just put it back on. I just put shit on TV.
Is it the Roman Empire thing on Netflix?
Yeah, I just put it on while I'm doing crosswords, you know?
Something to fucking keep the brain occupied.
Yeah, when I'm playing, I'm just trying not to think about death. I got all pumped because I was bitching to Shane about how Louis doesn't have the show Louis on streaming.
Yeah.
And then out of nowhere, he fucking pops up on my YouTube with Bobby Kelly, an absolute unit, by the way.
Yeah.
And fucking sitting there, and they're like, oh, dude, this is back on streaming. So I got it. And I started watching it, and like, dude, when I watched it the first time, I must have been 27, 28.
Yeah.
And I was like, this is the funniest show. This dude's the funniest guy. And Matt had brought us to see him live, and I was like, I never laughed that hard in my life.
Yeah.
I'd never seen it. You know, the crazy thing was, I've never seen a comedy show. I saw Jimmy Fallon once. He opened up, you know, some guy at, I went to Westchester for a semester and they had a comedy show.
Yeah.
And a guy from Downingtown opened up and he did like a bunch of like songs and like did like local jokes.
Yeah.
And we all thought he was funny. I was stoned out of my fucking mind.
Reps in.
Me and Kev from up north ate a bunch of fucking weed brownies, dude. So I don't know how real any of this is.
Right.
But fucking Jimmy Fallon got up and he started doing his hokey shit. And this was right before he was on Saturday Night Live. He was doing a comedy tour of the colleges. Did you ever see that show? What was that fucking show?
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about.
Whatever, the guy.
I know what I'm talking about. So he was doing that tour and he got booed off the fucking stage at Westside. Me and Kev were sitting up front.
Are you serious?
He fucking bombed, dude, and he got booed off the stage. It was fucking insane. But anyway, that was my first comedy show. Second,
is that the one where you said they called him a faggot?
Yeah, maybe I said something. I don't know. But fucking,
you were high on pot.
Yeah, I mean, he was like, you know, he was like kind of our age.
Yeah,
you know, he really did come on stage with like the thing of like, I'm gonna steal your girl attitude, but he was also doing that whole like, I'm a little shy guy thing.
Oh yeah,
it's fucking pissing me off.
Jesus.
But
so you had to give him an insult.
Dude, I'm not gonna tell stories about this deaf kid. He's fucking hilarious. Anyway, I can hear the birds.
joke for one person.
Yeah, sorry. Apologies. What do you call it? But then my next comedy show was Louis.
Are you
like,
fucking
a decade later?
Holy fuck!
You know what I mean? Like, so I saw Louis. Matt took me to see Louis, and I was like, holy shit, this is awesome.
Yeah.
I was like, this is so great to see. So that was like my second one. But then when I saw the show, I was like, this is hilarious. I rewatched it and it's so depressing. Louis's like just talking about being old.
Yeah.
And it's all the shit I think about and say. I don't know if he incepted this into my fucking mind or what.
The egg may have been planted.
Or this is just the natural course of human minds.
Yeah.
But like he's talking about all this depressing shit about how like life's just getting worse and worse and it's never going to get better.
Yeah.
And like the best days are gone. Every day is going to be worse. And it's exponential. And I'm like sitting there watching being like, I've said this shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? To everyone I know.
Yeah.
I say this to Matt like every other day.
Yeah.
And
now look at how much of a fool Louis is. He gets to do a podcast with Matt and Shane.
And
what an idiot.
What do you call it? He's on stage and he's like, I'm 41. And I'm like, holy shit, dude. I would have thought he was like older than that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Looking back on it, he seemed like a way older dude. So, and the whole vibe of the show is very old and depressing.
Yeah, there is a lot of fucking like somber walking and shit like that.
But anyway, I fucking bought his last special.
Yeah.
Shane was like, dude, check out his last special. I bought it. One of the funniest things I've ever seen. Also, though, made me think about dying again. He talks about this shit like brazenly, dude.
Yeah.
And I'm not built for it, dude. Yeah, like, no, by myself. I'm at home and I'm watching it and I'm laughing. I mean, he definitely got me on some shit where I was like on my side cracking up.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, when he's going off about like dying and getting older and stuff, I'm getting like a physical feeling.
Gut feeling, yeah.
Of like fear.
Yeah.
And like, no, I don't want to think about this.
Close that door.
And then
please.
Like, he's like telling jokes and the whole crowd's laughing and I'm just all quiet at home in like a catastrophic death spiral of thought.
Tears running down your face. Like, yeah,
no tears. No tears.
Yeah. Speaking of which, bro, hear me out. And I've said it on a few other fucking podcasts. I just to look into it. You see all the fucking cattle dying, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Everyone wants to talk about coronavirus. Everyone talks about Trump coming back. What? And mind you, I don't know if this is in the Midwest. I know Idaho went hard as fuck on it. We said it on a previous podcast. This could be 5G. This thing wiping out these animals could
this
be 5G.
This whole shit of you pointing at me and going, mind you, is killing me.
I'm just telling you. These fuckers,
mind you.
You see the birds die from 5G all the time. No one's talking. 5G came and fucking went, dude.
You got to see HUD.
What's HUD?
HUD is the movie with Paul Newman where they fucking have to kill all the cattle. It's a great fucking movie.
I'll watch it.
I mean, I know black and whites are tough for people, but
I don't mind it. Paul Newman, black and whites are good on. They're good in my book.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but I see those fucking pictures and something doesn't sit right with me, dude.
I follow your gut, man. Your gut biome is strong.
I have a 5G bug. I'm not like I'm real fucking tripped out right now as to what the fuck is going on with all these cattle. Like a bunch of sheep just died. And like, dude,
I want to see this on a map, you know?
All I remember is Idaho went hard as fuck putting in fucking 5G. And like, dude, people have never been sicker. People's hearts have never been stopping. And it could all be a fucking fraud on the COVID-19 and it's really just 5G. Who knows? 5G might be a thing that you can talk to fucking aliens.
The alien shit is fucking killing me, bro.
What do you mean?
Like the disclosure. This is fucking insane.
It is insane, but I literally can't believe anything China says.
I hear you, but it's not just China. America's doing this too. There's a bunch of movies. I just saw that one with the fucking with William Shatner, where it's called A Terror in the Sky.
Oh yeah,
and
yeah.
Dude, the gear these nerds are wearing is some of the funniest. They make uniforms for themselves, but even their gear before, like the one guy's got like a Nebula shirt on that I want. It's fucking sick. You gotta see it.
Yeah,
they like see UFOs.
Yeah, something's up with that.
In California.
They're going to have to give us a good fucking... Like,
they're out by Alcatraz.
Really?
Yep.
They're going to have to give us a good new season.
Of what?
Whatever this is. Because of this life, COVID thing ain't it.
Yeah, yeah. This they're going to have to give us... Dude, you never got me that clip.
I can't find it.
Oh, fuck.
But this whole thing, they're going to have to give us aliens or something because it was dick as fuck what they did the last 3 years.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just phased. Like, if...
They are going hard as fuck with this alien stuff.
It's kind of like, dude, are they real? Like, are we? Is this all just going to record scratch and then be like aliens?
Yeah, that would be fucking terrifying.
Yeah, it'd be nuts, dude.
But cool at the same time because I'd be like, dude, you guys worked on me on mushrooms. Take me, please.
I don't know if those are the bros, man.
I'm Audi 5000. Yeah, the weirdness they're putting on all the alien shit is bizarre.
Yeah, it phased me just because it's like the TikTok thing. It was a slow rollout of like regular stuff, like Stephen Greer and stuff kind of ramped up. Actually, it pretty much started back when that kid from the band, you know what I'm talking about? Tom DeLong?
Yeah, yeah. Blink-182.
Yeah, Tom DeLong, like he went on Rogan and started this.
Yeah.
And then it went into like the Bob Lazar thing. Like Rogan's been a big fucking...
Yeah, he's a UFO boy.
He's a big UFO boy.
There's one behind his head.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, man, like fucking... If they slow roll out aliens, this is going to be insane.
This may just be the Fonz jumping the shark, though. Like the news every week, just alien sighting over Alcatraz.
Yeah, it's not like the first time. This isn't the first time they've done this.
Yeah. Time is.
They just kind of seem serious now.
Yeah, I mean, I pray to God. I'll take aliens over fucking Biden's like out talking about like, oh, we need to save up money for the next pandemic.
Oh, yeah. What was that? I heard you playing that on the phone earlier.
Oh, I got it right here. Hold on. Yeah, I don't know what his deal is or, like, why he's doing this. Let me see. Here you go. Twitter.
What's up, Twitter world?
This year, we do need more money. But we don't just need more money for vaccines for children eventually. We need more money to plan for the second pandemic. There's going to be another pandemic. We have to think ahead. And that's not something the last outfit did very well. That's something we've been doing for fairly
get long. Over it.
That's
dude.
Why we need the money.
They're literally obsessed.
I don't understand how that makes sense, bro. Like, a 1-in-100-year pandemic happens. Like, dude, obviously we need more money for the pandemic. It's like, dude, we don't have any money. What do you want to do, tax us?
I think they want to do that shit they were talking about in No Agenda, where it's like they want to get this. They need to keep going real hard until this COVID vaccine becomes part of the schedule, and then their liability will be underneath all the rest of it. You know what
and
I mean?
And, dude, they have a bunch of
Because like, remember when I was telling you about the Elestra shit? The FDA will approve anything.
Dude, Oxford just came out with the study that, like, 94% of new medicines that are out currently are just based on, like, real loose science. Like, there's no stringent testing or anything.
Yeah, the FDA is probably just bought and sold.
Yeah, I mean, it's fucking crazy because something's going to happen because a lot of those COVID vaccines, quote-unquote, expire on fucking in July. So something, they're gonna have to fucking do something to keep the ball rolling.
I just don't like that. They're giving it to the little babies, and it's fucking insane.
I mean,
like,
dude,
how are you going to do an RNA thing to a fucking 6-month-old.
Yeah, dude who barely has the D in his DNA, bro.
You might be changing them. You know what I mean? For
it's
good.
It's fucked, bro.
It's really fucked.
Yeah, like...
And, like, there are major side effects.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't give shit to a 6-month-old.
No. The shit they're approving for kids, they're not letting you get in, like, fucking Europe.
It's wild that there's a... There's a short supply of baby formula, right?
Yeah.
But then there's vaccines for 6-month-old.
Well, they're about to fucking...
It's like, this, hey, man, this kind of looks like a depopulation program.
Yeah, they're about to fucking expire, so let's get a bunch of kids on them, and they'll be like, ah, never mind. Because Pfizer just came out again, and they tried to... It's, like, fully out in the news. Their efficacy after 1 week is, like, 12%, then down to 1.
Yeah, right.
And it's, like, took the scourge... Everyone fucking retard. You should have got vaccinated.
So they're just openly saying now, like, when you get the shot, you barely have any resistance.
Yes.
And then after a little while, you have none.
Yes.
But these nanobots that probably get activated by 5G are in you forever? Or does your body just, like, sort out these metals?
Don't think so. Don't know. But the one thing I do know is those who are not vaccinated are having way less worse symptoms than those who are vaccinated.
Dude, it's crazy because people are just gone with that shit.
They're completely lost.
People are, like, vaxxed and triple boosted, and they'll get sick.
Yeah.
Like, my buddy, he got COVID.
After being vaccinated.
After being vaccinated, and after having that as a requirement for his wedding. I'm sorry.
It's just, like, it's real annoying because you can't even break someone's balls on that shit. And, mind you, I'm not fucking bragging, but I was out this weekend. Yeah, my off shrift. Yeah, I'll get into on Friday. Yeah. But I went right up to this chick, and, like, we start talking, and I'm like, I am on, like, we were talking, my one buddy's like, oh, this is cool. It's like, I have to get this out of here because I'm not fucking summer eating myself later on. I was like, I'm unvaccinated, just so fucking you guys know. Immediately, dude, we're done with this conversation. Fuck you. All of our friends fucking hate me, all this shit.
It's crazy, man.
Didn't matter, dude. After fucking 5 minutes, literally
with
didn't
matter.
With
that body, with that face, she couldn't resist.
I told her, I was like, dude.
Now, did you learn all this from Tate Yu or what?
No, this is just fucking me. And I said, I know people who fucking damn right died for the vaccine. RIP Uncle fucking Charlie. I was like, there's no way I'm getting that shit after seeing that. And she was like, oh, but the people I took care of on ventilators. And you know what I said to her? Think I simped?
No, you said ventilators
fuck
killed
no,
people.
Brother. I said, you put those fuckers on the ventilators, you fucking killed them.
Yeah.
I was, that was 28 grand in the fucking... in the hospital's pocket. Ventilators don't fucking help
people.
That's
fire with
fire,
bro.
Sorry, didn't work. Still, I remain a victor.
You were just blowing on the kindling there. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, my God. Opposites attract. Anyway, here's another fucking weird clip from Biden.
You guys are like the yin and the yang.
Congress criticizing me today for high gas prices in America. Are you now saying we were wrong to support Ukraine?
Yes.
Are you saying we were wrong to stand up to Putin? Are you saying that we would rather have lower gas prices in America and Putin's iron fist in Europe? I don't believe that.
Insane, dude. This is what's going on in the news now. We need UFOs. Like, that's what it is. Like, that is the most, like, I don't give a fuck about the Ukraine.
Like,
give me buck 29.
That, when you're a little kid, that shit happens all the time, and the training wheels stop it.
What?
Like, the bike, like, the training wheels stop it.
Yeah.
That's what they're for.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just that kind of a fall.
Oh, yeah, obviously.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, kids are good when they're going.
Yeah.
The bike's good in motion. It's for, like, when you stop.
Yeah.
Kids fucking go to the side. But the training, then they can hold on to the bike because the training wheels.
He had one of those faggy, like, fucking clip-on pedals, though.
I know, yeah.
I mean, personally, if every single biker in the fucking world felt at the same time, I'd be a happier guy. I fucking hate them. You don't need clips into your
fucking
bike.
Dude, there
was
a fucking dude.
You're a pussy.
There was a dude riding a bike on Lincoln Drive the other day.
Kill yourself.
And I was like, I thought he was trying to do that. He was like a biker, like a racer.
They're so annoying, dude.
He was going against traffic, so I don't know what happened to him, T's and P's, but he was he was whipping. He was trying to keep up with the cars, but the cars were like, you know, they're 25, 35. It's like, dude, they're flying.
Yeah.
It's around bends. This is a very dangerous road if you're on a bike and there's no shoulder.
Yeah, it's just not a place to be on a bike. I don't understand where they get this like cock attitude and like this hard-o mentality where they can fuck people up.
It's just like a really cool history. Like, it's always been like that. In the 80s, they had like a movie. I can't remember the name of this fucking movie, dude, but chick sweated this dude in it. And when he was like, I'm going to be a cyclist. And it was like,
that's
fucking,
where all the gear came from.
Yeah, it's like all the weird like French hats and the skinny shirts and all that. And fucking, I can't remember the name of this. I fucked a chick that was obsessed with. Was obsessed.
Ass or pussy, dude? You gotta tell me, motherfucker.
Bro, all three, brother. Oh, okay. Actually, no, I'm just fucking around.
I thought it'd be a good story. Yeah.
I mean, just two. I mean, three, I was just fucking around.
Three, you're a bit of a fucking pig.
Yeah, I'm not
but,
doing that.
Yeah, I mean, the bikers are completely debunked by the existence of my mom and dad. Like, my mom and dad don't have an athletic
bone. Oh, yeah, they ride bikes. Yeah, your dad's a bike enthusiast.
He rides a bike from fucking Philadelphia all the way to fucking AC. And he just goes on fun fucking trips. So if you're going to tell me you're fucking lighting the world on fire, throwing on fucking ass pads and spandex and shit, dude, get the fuck over yourself.
You know what else is fucking nuts that I've seen them? Oh, shit, hold on, Bandai videos playing.
Dude. What are you trying to look up?
I want to look up the name of that bike movie.
Oh. Yeah. Dude, and like they get like shit talked by fucking bikers when they're on their way down to AC for that tour to shore.
Oh, dude, that's what I was going to say. Like there's also a whole world of bikers that bike, then stop at like fucking microbrews.
It's CrossFit.
And they rip like a ton of fucking craft beers and then hop on their bikes. It's like, dude, that's drinking and driving, brother.
Yeah, dude. I really like that whole, anytime I think of the cyclists, this could be completely wrong, and I'm just talking on my ass. I think about Homeland and the fucking one dude. It may have been Homeland or it may have been a completely different show, but I just think a dude's getting cucked anytime I see those fucking cyclist gear.
Yeah, dude, 1979's Breaking Away. When I was younger, I was with an older woman that was obsessed with this film.
Dude, save the pussy stories for the Patreon, for the love of fucking God, bro.
Sorry.
There's too many.
It was like very young. She was like telling me all about like Breaking Away is so cool and Fleetwood Mac and Stevie Nicks is so cool. Lindsey Buckingham. And I was like, nice. Yeah, this is so cool.
Yeah.
I also love Bruce Springsteen.
Before we sign off for the night, I just want
to. Oh, we can keep going, man.
I fucking fully believe in conspiracy theories. But when I fucking go on Matt and Shane's subreddit and I see a whole post about how this whole podcast is a psyop and we're
really
getting
pussy. You got to get out of the comments, man.
You got to be out of your mind. I just didn't get pussy since November, bro.
What was it? What were they saying?
Saying we're just putting on an incel thing to appease people. And like,
dude, I'm not an incel. I've literally gotten more pussy than Matt.
Dude, on record?
On record, all three of your brothers.
Okay.
I have four... long relationships.
Yeah.
What the fuck are they talking about?
They know you for 2 years, dude.
Yeah. I mean, an hour. You don't know me, bro.
Exactly.
You don't know me.
Exactly.
Okay, bro.
Fucking tell them, dude. Shit pisses me off when I see that stuff. And then it starts to make me believe all my conspiracies.
I'm just having a tough time right now in our current fucking climate.
Yeah.
And I'm, you know, things don't feel good.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
If you stretch it out, though, and it was a glass, the glass would mostly be full.
No, I mean, if I did, listen.
For adult life.
Let's just say I understand why it's called getting lucky.
You're well versed in the female anatomy.
I'm just saying that it's getting lucky, man. You're lucky. If you found a babe, you're lucky.
Yes.
It's dark. It's out. Dark out here. It's cold.
No flashlights either.
Yeah. I'm in a cave on Tatooine.
What? Why did the Obi-Wan fuck you
dude,
up so
chill,
bad?
Chill, man. You know they're gonna come at my neck, dude. I'm talking about fucking Kenobi.
Oh, people fuck with Star Wars. I fuck with Star Wars.
All I'm saying, bro, is there's girls out there. I know that. It's just hard to find them right now. And like you said, they're either Jedi or Sith.
Yes.
There's no in between. Nobody's living in the real world anymore.
Yes, 100%. It is crazy.
Like you were hitting me last week with that we are actually based and everybody's gone.
Yes.
That's pretty much what it is.
I would say so.
I know that's what a crazy person would say too. So I'm aware of that.
Yeah, that's just in regards to...
It's just you get in this world where... I'll give you an example. I was talking to a girl, chubby, and I'm texting her on Hinge or whatever. And pretty much straight off the bat, she's like, so what are you into? Do you like books, music?
That's infuriating.
Or do you like books, music, podcasts, stuff like that? I said, yeah, to all three. And then she's like, well, what podcast do you like? I was like, very vague. Just, oh, I'll pretty much listen to anything. I just like to learn stuff, you know?
Yeah.
And she's like, what do you think about Joe Rogan? And I was like, he's cool. He's got some guests sometimes. And she's like, he's a twat waffle. Never heard that one before.
Twat waffle?
Yeah. I was like...
Once you get that fucking...
They're all very
insults,
anti... Like, there's a whole world of, like, anti, like, Joe Rogan type dudes. You know?
What are they into? Like, did she say what she listens to?
She's into, like, being a witch, spirituality.
Really?
Yeah, all this stuff.
Yeah, this one...
Like, you know, the body keeps the score... This kind of stuff.
The body keeps the school.
You know, like, you know, fucking healing through your...
Sure,
you
sure,
know,
sure.
This kind of stuff.
Yeah, I mean...
I'm sure there's crystals and home remedies coming down the pike. But then that's what I'm saying. It's like, I'm talking to her and I can... You know, it's just the facial hair is a tough one to get past.
Right. Wax it.
For me.
Yeah, I mean, dude, I
stay on top of it. I'm never going to know it's there. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, just fucking...
I can't talk.
Just hit that shit. You got a beard, so yeah. You can't really talk shit. Yeah, it does infuriate me when chicks like, what are you interested in? And it's like, I currently just like working.
It's fucking every time I start one of these things up, I feel like Indiana Jones walking on like the Jehovah Stones in Last Crusade. It's like, yeah. I'm like sitting there like, I'm guessing like, that's probably a good one. You know what I mean?
And that's what it is.
I just keep them all like real loosey-goosey.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it is. Like,
I know nothing's coming of any of them.
Yeah.
They're never going to want to meet up. They're never going to want to hang out. If we hang out, it's just going to be weird as fuck.
Especially...
I never, like, dude, you can call me insult all you want. I never picked up girls. I would just be around enough to kind of start to be friends with a girl.
Yes.
And I like them for them. I get to meet them.
Hey, man.
And I get to know them, and I'm like, oh, I like this girl.
You're not an iGen pussy.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm demisexual.
What the fuck does that mean, bro?
Dude, I don't know. It's one of these tags that they put up.
Yeah. Once you start getting into like the world of like not meaner insults, but like cock jockey and twat waffle.
I've never heard of it before, yeah.
It's just nerd shit. Like, you're just a fucking real big nerd if you're hitting people with that stuff. Like, you're probably obsessed with Jay and Silent Bob. For real, like, that's, like, the kind of person that is.
I mean,
is.
Dogma kind of rules.
I'm just saying, like, that's your world. You're just a little bit fucking nerdy. And then, like, for some reason, that world of nerds got oddly liberal.
Yeah, right.
Like they stopped watching Orgasmo. They stopped fucking watching Jay and Silent Bob. And then they just got real liberal, and they have real liberal sniz, and they don't like having fucking fun.
I do believe, I am on board with all the people that say that it replaced a religion. And that like religion, like the way that I was when I was a kid, and I made those little notebooks and stuff, like I needed that at the time.
Oh, yeah.
I needed like, I constantly went on like mythic quests in my head. I love these stories. You know what I mean? Yeah. So like I need like endless like
You were an asshat.
What?
Nah, it's just another fucking faggy thing.
Yeah, like
shit pisses me off.
Well, anyway, I'm just saying like when I was a little kid, like that shit was like big to me. Like I would be like get home, work on my religion book, put my headphones on, listen to CDs, play. I used to play Battle of Olympus. It's an old Nintendo game, and I didn't listen to the music. I would put on my U2 CD.
Yeah.
And I would, that's awesome. I would blast, because I can picture it right now. I can picture playing the game.
Yeah.
And going through all the Greek temples and going through the Peloponnesian forest, blasting fucking Pride. Blasting With or Without You.
With or Without You is a and great singing, song. And
singing in my room and stuff. My mom probably thought I was nuts.
Definitely.
And then if I wanted to watch TV, we only had a couple channels. So I watched like reruns of like Hogan's Heroes, What's Happening Now, you know, Different Strokes. Different Strokes was my jam.
Really?
Love adopted kid stories.
Yeah,
but like all this religion shit, like if you don't have the religion stuff, you need it.
Yeah.
It's like part of you. You can have enough of it and be like, I'm full for now. Yeah. I'll come back to that. But I think these kids went on like an atheist kick and there's nothing for them to believe in. And then the more like ideological,
it keeps the kids going. Even if you don't fucking believe it, if a kid starts asking like, "What are we?" and all this stuff, it's like you got to have some sort of base. And you're not just going to say you're you, yeah, unless you're like an autistic freak.
The more like a political team can tap into,
oh yeah,
like just mimicking other things that have worked in religion, it's mm-hmm. game over. Because it's like that just fits into the slot. It's like this is our team.
Yes.
This is heresy. You can't say that about COVID. We believe in, so like, these signs that they put out, these lawn signs and door signs and window signs and shit, they are like the creed.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? That's like, we believe in one God, Father Almighty.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Damn, dude, you're spitting hard right now.
Whatever, dude. You need to get me activated. If you come at me, bro, you come dude. At me and you start calling me an incel again.
Yeah.
It's like, bro.
And it's a show.
And it, yeah, please. And, but it hurt.
You don't think I want to be talking pussy every fucking yeah. week, you idiots?
You don't think it hurts for me to sit here and be afraid? You think I'd be afraid of a fucking Louis hour-long comedy special if I was by myself? Or if I wasn't by myself?
Yeah.
If there was someone there, I'd be like, this is funny. We're having a good time.
You believe people even worried
yeah.
about this?
It's like, oh, yeah. He's not afraid of getting old and dying. Isn't that funny, honey?
Yeah, way easier.
Yeah. I think my temperature drops, for real.
Oh yeah,
like Louis starts talking about it, I'm getting colder.
Yeah, whatever was going on with me like a few weeks back, it was like stomach pains, leg pains. I'm fucked. I feel fucking weird. Oh my god.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, imagine what cancer feels like.
I know. That's what I thought. Yeah. Like in my head, at one point, I was like, "Am I getting cancer?"
Yeah, like dude, I was at yoga and I, you know, I'm constantly dehydrated, not sleeping a lot.
Yeah.
Fucking. Probably should ease up on the fucking mushies, but whatever. And I'm.
What do you add a day?
Whatever, dude. Okay. I'm doing one of the things, and my neck cramped up.
Oof.
And then I was like, I'm having a stroke.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
So, oh Lord.
That's what I'm saying. Like that kind of shit. I don't know. Like my mom was a real, not my mom now, but my mom before was a real hypochondriac.
Yeah.
Couldn't go over bridges.
For real?
Oh yeah, like very afraid of a ton of shit.
Amazing.
And I wonder sometimes if she gave herself the cancer. Now I know that's fucked up to say.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. I get what you're saying.
But though. Like she had, like it's not she
that did, much stress on the body.
She didn't. She didn't. Absolutely, she didn't.
Yeah.
Every woman in our neighborhood had thyroid problems. I'm not coming at the dude that built our fucking development.
Dead now.
But.
Potentially
something was up with the water where we grew up, where it was definitely. Fucked up, and they all got sick. But my mom ended up getting the sickest for yeah. the longest.
She was the sickest.
And if you're like one of these people that is like kind of nuts,
yeah,
sickness,
you're gonna feel like shit.
Sickness is like a really hard thing to deal with, like recovering and like always knowing that it can, what do they call it, come out of
remission.
Remission.
Yeah.
You know,
I mean, if you're stressed to the max, it turns your hair gray. So like if you have cancer and you're stressed to the max, you have cancer harder.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Just so you know, I never got to know her as an adult. And I always just, I wonder like what she would be like.
Yeah. That's
because I'm almost as old as she ever got. So I'm confused about like, it's just funny to me to think about. Because yeah, then I'll sit there and like Louis talking about like how his mom just died. And it's like, damn, dude, like, fucking, my mom didn't get to live very long.
Not at all.
And the last, like, if she was my age now, she would already have cancer.
That's fucking crazy.
You know what I mean? So, like, that was not a good ride.
Yeah.
And, like, not all, that's the other thing. I'm like, you know, not all stories end good, dude. And then you got to start wondering if you're one of them. And it's like, yeah, hey man, I'm just saying. Yeah. Like I started thinking about this shit. This one, these are my
catastrophic. Man, please.
These are my these are my catastrophic negative death spirals I get into. All right, I'm sorry. I'm fucking bombing this podcast.
Just a little food for thought. A little
I mean, everybody thinks they're the hero of their story, man. Yeah. But, you know.
Sometimes
stories are just like, oh, that fucking ended weird.
I don't know what the fuck it's going to do to the children. Like you were talking about, like this, like how these people have adopted science as a religion, kind of, like their science. If you're a kid and like, you know, you were saying, you're writing you're drawing those pictures, having fun, mom, dad, brother, sister, all that makes sense. If you were born, you become sentient.
I'm sentient.
7, 8 years old. World shuts down, worldwide pandemic. Your mom and dad freak the fuck out. Put you in a mask all the time. They're always freaking out. And then your dad becomes a fucking woman.
Dude,
I was making you call him mama.
I was showing Tom. I have this.
What?
I could show it to you.
I watched the video.
Oh, I showed it to you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I sent it to you.
It's fucking crazy.
Yeah, that's someone's dad. That's someone's dad that now is lost their mind, thinks they're a chick.
Yeah.
And I mean, dude, like you might as well just fucking lock your kid up. Kid's fucked.
They're so gone too because they're like, I showed them a children's book and they completely get it. I was like, an 8-year-old gets it. An 8-year-old who just figured out that chick. I mean, dude, when I was 8, I knew that chicks didn't have dicks, but I didn't know what the fuck they actually had. So like, if you're telling an 8-year-old I'm a girl now, you're fucking rocking my world.
Oh yeah, I didn't see like the inner workings of any of that shit till I was like 12 or 13. I thought it was Mini Butt City.
What?
I thought it was Mini Butt City, dude.
Yeah. Yeah.
I thought it was just Mini Butt in the front, bigger butt double in the back. Butt. Yeah.
I
had no idea there was all that going on.
There's
going
to be some weird shit, and it, like the Zoomers that are walking around the city now, dude, they're all dressed like Neo out of the Matrix. It's fucking insane. I have no idea what this group of children is going to be like.
We are the batteries.
Dude, for real. Like, I was at Acme yesterday, and like these people were literally dressing like psychopaths, and not like you're wearing skimpy stuff. It's like you're just wearing shit from 2000, but you're like they're dressing like JP from Grandma's Boy.
Yeah,
and like,
but serious, but for real.
Dead fucking serious, and like I'm counterculture.
I guess, man. I mean, I'm not gonna knock on the younglings.
It's just hilarious to watch them all dress like JP from Grandma's.
They're our only hope. They're the next ones up.
And fucking people's parents are.
I'm on the back burner.
Yeah. All you can do is be a beacon of light and say, this is normal. I am a dude.
You know you're a dude.
Yeah, it is very.
They know in their hearts. You know what I mean?
You think, dude? You don't think they know when they take a piss?
They're just messed up, man.
Fucking chill with doing that to your kid, though. Don't make them call your mama and put on lipstick.
I don't think they do.
What?
Yeah, I don't think they like. I think they still hold it down like they're the dad.
There's a video of this one fucking explaining to with their kids that they're mama.
Oh,
they know,
okay.
Like, and they know I'm mama because they read a book about it. And like, there's fucking the teachers are the worst. If you go on Libs TikTok on Twitter, the teachers are like showing kids pride books and stuff. It's fucking crazy.
Yeah, I don't know.
You can't be hit me with that. Like, second grade, I was watching Cinemax. You can't be hit me in kindergarten with gay.
Like with the real gay.
With the real gay. Like, what? That's a mind melter.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't know.
You're
like,
kind of.
I was
like,
in first grade and I was already like, this is my girlfriend.
Obviously.
I tried to go out with the same chick for like fucking 3 years.
You're straight.
And we were going out. Like, I was like, I got in my first fight because this other dude gave M&Ms to her.
Yeah.
It was fucking on.
The slippery slope is like, everyone has preferences. If LeBron James comes out with a shoe, all these kids are going to get it. If Kevin Durant comes out with a shoe, even if the shoe is fucking retarded looking, there's going to be kids who get the shoe just to be fucking fitting in. If you start telling fucking 8-year-olds and 9-year-olds like, oh no, boys can kiss boys, you're kind of fucking with their heads.
Yeah, I never really got the fitting in thing. I think that might be what my problem is.
Never really fit any bit of an
outsider. That's what I was telling that to Matt. I was like, I don't really fit in anywhere. That's the hard part of going out.
Yeah, you're a man.
There's nowhere I go, like, to socialize where I'm like, this makes sense that I'm here.
Yeah.
Well, you said the just chill bars is
chill bars, but I mean
pretty much yeah. Pool hall.
Pool hall. Nah, that'd be nice.
You're a pool hall junkie.
But yeah, most of the time I don't feel I feel like out of whack. You know,
the man on the moon.
Yeah,
Kid Cudi. You got to listen to the intro, "Man on the Moon." And
I'll check it out.
If you put this to the fucking
play it, play us out.
Hold
on,
hold on, 1 second.
Play us out on it, dude.
You good?
All right, run it.
What were you saying?